Hare Krishna. It does not matter how slowly you go, as long as you do not stop. Confucius. We live in an age that stresses speed and acceleration. Our cars move faster and faster. Our planes move faster and faster. We want our devices to start faster and faster. We would like to have net connections that are faster and faster. Now, amidst this emphasis on speed, and especially on the human capacity through technology to increase the speed of doing things, we may sometimes forget that we human beings ourselves are not machines which can be simply accelerated, Also, we may forget that there are things in nature which cannot be accelerated. They will go at their pace. For example, if a person sows some crops, after the crops are sown, the harvesting season has to come and then the crops will grow. Or for that matter, there may be a small child. The child cannot grow at accelerated pace, that pace. The child will grow at its own pace till they become a young boy, then a youth, teenager, a youth, then a man. So that's how there is a speed at which nature moves. Or for that matter, say, when a man and woman come together, they get married, and they desire to have a child. At that time, after conception happens, the period of gestation cannot be fast-forwarded. It will take its own time, and eventually after that, delivery will take place. So in the same spirit, we need to understand that things take their own pace. And just as in nature we observe and we understand, let's say a mango tree will not grow at the same pace as, say, some wheat grains. So similarly, just as we appreciate the difference between different things in nature and the pace at which they grow, we also have to appreciate that each one of us is a different individual. And because we are different individuals, we have our own natures, we have our own capacities, we have our own interests, and we will grow at our own pace. This pace can't be changed. And sometimes we may compare ourselves with others, and somebody who is able to go very fast, we may compare ourselves with them and feel inferior. Oh, why can't I go that fast? However, they are different individuals, we are different individuals. We just simply need to go at our pace. And if our pace is slow, that doesn't matter. We will grow at our pace. And this wisdom has been there traditionally within the world's great traditions. Wisdom traditions. So, for example, there is the parable of the tortoise and the hare. The hare runs very fast but then becomes overconfident and goes off to sleep. And the tortoise then moves steadily onwards and reaches the destination before the hare. So, like that, we all will move at our pace. And in the Bhagavad Gita, it is described that we all have our swabhava. Our own innate nature, swabhava jena kaunteya nibaddha sveina karmana. That we will all work according to our nature. And according to our nature, we will all find that a particular pace is comfortable for us. So rather than wanting to accelerate the pace and thinking that, oh, if I get fast ahead, that's the success of my life. Actually, this notion comes from a fundamental misunderstanding of the driving metaphor of life. Sometimes, because we live in such a competitive society, we see life as a sprint, like a short 100 meter race. But life is more like a 100 kilometer marathon. Yes, in life, there might be some phases when there are sprints. We have certain deadlines, we have certain exams, and we have to complete some project before that. We have to do some studies before that. That's fine. So there may be some phases when we need to run like in sprints, very fast. But overall, you know, life is like a marathon, wherein speed is important. But what is more important is stamina. If somebody in the marathon runs very fast, and then they exhaust themselves, and then later on, they'll be so drained that they will not have the capacity to run even at a mediocre speed, what to speak of fast. That's why to have a sense of balance, we need to have the right metaphor for life. And we get a spiritual vision of life from the Bhagavad Gita. We understand that life is not just about this achievement, this target, this deadline. Yes, achievements are important. But more important than achievement is fulfillment. And fulfillment comes when we act true to our nature. When we do the best that we can do without worrying about what who else is doing. When we just bring out our best, and when we make the contribution that we are meant to make, that is when we get fulfillment. So therefore, we consider achievement here and fulfillment here. We need to focus. By speed, we might get some achievements, but then there are cases of burnout, where people run so fast, they achieve so much, but then they get exhausted, they get fried out. But rather, those who sustain themselves, they will also achieve, but more importantly, they will be fulfilled. So by a spiritual vision of life, we can have a balanced approach towards life, where we focus not on how slow or how fast we are moving, but we keep moving. You know, if we are having a materialistic view of life, if we achieve something, we may become elated. And I think, now I have achieved, now I am great, now I have arrived. But actually life moves on. And we will stay stuck resting on the laurels of our achievement. Or we may otherwise become dejected because we don't achieve something. Again, we may give up. But the steadiness to persevere will come when we see that in some sprints we may win, in some sprints we may lose, but life is a marathon. And in the long run, how fast or how slow we move doesn't matter as much as whether we keep moving or not. And if we have a vision that life is meant for spiritual evolution, for connecting with our source, God, Krishna, and developing our loving devotion to Him, then when we work in a mood of contribution for His pleasure, then even if sometimes we achieve, we don't achieve, still that connection brings fulfillment, and that connection gives us the confidence to move on through life's ups and downs and persevere towards worthwhile achievement and ultimately towards enduring fulfillment. Thank you. Hare Krishna.